Hello? Is this thing on? I know it is. I'm checking OBS right now. So don't lie. Even if he said no, I would have known you heard me. So that wouldn't have worked on me. Alright, it might have. The first time, maybe. He caught me on a sleepy day. Which today is. Not too sleepy, though. It's not the sleepiest day I've had. But it's getting there. Probably will be by the end of the stream. We'll see how much vim and vigor I have. What is vim, by the way? Does anyone know? Do I know? No. That's why I'm looking it up. Vim meaning. Energy and enthusiasm. Interesting. What does it mean in British? Well, I assume it means the same thing it means in English. You know, just general English. Google, thank you. I don't know why we have to know what it means in British. British is not a language. Last I checked, it's even less of a language than Americanized English, in my opinion. They got words like blimey-wimey over there. That's ridiculous. You would never catch me saying that. You'd just catch me saying stuff like riz, fam. That's the only dumb word that's ever existed in American English. Did they say riz in Britain? Is that caught on over there? It shouldn't. I hope it don't, for their sake. But did it? I wonder. Alright, let's swap over to the thing. Here's this. Here I am, doing art again. We're on page 15 or so. Of the prologue. I've done some other stuff too. But I'll wait to see if more people show up before I start going into that, because it would be a lot to explain multiple times. Look this up. Let me just see something real quick. And yeah, that's good. Okay, I now know exactly what I'm doing. Perfect. I gotta get rid of all this. Then I gotta go here and here. I had to look up what an eye looked like in profile. And now I know. How did those medieval dudes do it? I don't have a photographic memory. If I had to look up the profile of a face, I'd forget immediately. And then there'd be nothing. I'd have, a book with somebody else's drawing in it? Maybe one of my own studies? I guess that's what they would do. Just compile stuff. Be your own source, if you had to. Which makes sense. What page don't got words on it? Does this one got words on it? I think it's good. Okay, no words on it. Good. I can use this for reference still. I love when I don't finish my pages, pages all the way. Let's move this over here. We don't need color until maybe a different stream entirely. Getting a little bold, assuming I can make it to color this stream. I would like to finish the liner, as per usual, but we'll see what happens. I'm very particular about facial anatomy, though. At least my own, not other people's, because that would mean I would think I'm better than them, and I am not. I would never critique. Even when asked for, it's very difficult to get something out of me by way of criticism. In college, we had mandatory participation in critiques, because obviously you're paying for the course, and the professors, if they care at all, will want you to get that experience, because it's not one you're going to get a whole lot outside of college. I have been critiqued outside of any school environment precisely zero times. So that's just never going to happen. Unless you actively seek it out. Or you are unlucky enough to meet a jerkwad on the internet who's like, Yeah, you drew, I don't know how else to say this, the fibula is all messed up, and it's not called the fibula. Is it the fibula? Am I missing something? If they call it the fibula, they're also lying, so don't listen to them. Unless it is the fibula. The tibia and the fibula. It is the fibula. I was dumb and then smart. I should just trust myself more often. I don't. That's my issue. It's my one problem that I have. Everything else is perfect. Except for that one thing. Which is a lack of faith in how perfect I am. It's inspiring, honestly. You should all learn a little something. His eye looks messed up. And I know it's supposed to look messed up, but it looks a little too messed up. Move it. Enlargen. Oh yeah, I can do this. I forgot. See what it... We should just draw it like this. That looks good. Looks like a dapper gent. His eyes are a little small and pushed too far back, I think. Move that on over. Maybe about here? Where? His eyes can be pretty sunken if you really want them to. And I do. Here's a little pro tip from me to you. He has glasses on right here, but I don't want to draw them a lot, so when they throw him to the ground, which is happening in this panel here, his glasses fall off, so I don't have to draw them anymore. It's kind of my art hack to you, is to just give up. But make sure it fits within your narrative so people don't get mad at you. It's very clever and smart. Alright, now, Dahlia, what the... forgive me for saying this, what the hell do you look like? Give me your face. This angle is fine. Excuse me, my dogs are barking again? Why? We got a new mailbox, by the way. For anyone who wasn't here. For anyone checking this in the future for posterity. I had an old guy fall asleep behind his car, plowed our mailbox out of the ground, was uninjured. Thankfully. But yeah, now we got a new mailbox. Out of that whole team. It's a smaller one than we had before, which I am personally upset by. Yeah, I'm gonna need to sketch out. I forget that when I do this, I need to just commit to doing other thumbnails. Even though I don't want to, and I want to get straight into the other stuff. Like the line art, but you know. Two sets of thumbnails is usually how it goes. If your neck was turned this way, wouldn't it be this one that's highlighted? Yeah, well, I guess it depends. Depends. Which way does your freaking thing go again? Well, this is actually profoundly unhelpful. Every panel just shows the wrong thing. What about here? That doesn't show it either. Which fold of the kimono overlaps with which fold? Is what I require in terms of knowledge. That's it, I'll open it myself. It's right over left. Okay, good. Have I even been consistent with that? I'll have to check that later. Right over left. Our right over our left, not her right over her left. So it goes like this, and then this would go into there. Okay. I have remembered clothing. And how to. And for, and henceforth, and whatnot. Oh, I can't wait till I get to an action sequence. There's one in the prologue, it's just not here yet. It'll show up. Honestly, I say I'm about halfway through the prologue, but once I get past the dialogue and I get into the action sequences, it might be pretty... I might quicken the pace a bit, because there's not going to be as many panels per page, I don't think. That actually, you know what, now that I'm thinking about it, it might take longer, because I'm going to be spending more time on each panel, because I can't help myself. But we're not there yet, so we can worry about that later. That's a future Zotan problem, and that guy... We don't care about him, often. Frick him. He deserves everything that's coming to him, mainly because present Zotan is also also a bad person. To himself. What does this guy look like? Oh, I really did not help myself with this depiction of this gentleman. Alright, let's try it out then. Vest was pretty simplified, because that's just how it had to be. Let's see, parted hair down here. What Pikmin would you be, Zotan? Also, what's up, Mask? What Pikmin would I be? Let me think for a moment. I don't know anything that's new to four. So you'll have to forgive me about my knowledge of the Pikmin types if there's one that you think would be more appropriate. I think I would be... Probably the white Pikmin. You know? That's not just a race thing either. That's just, you know, they're weak. They inflict less damage when you attack enemies with them. So yeah, probably that. They have red eyes. I have bloodshot eyes a lot. Very dry over here. So I think I'd be a white Pikmin. They're weak little scramble dudes. With red eyes. I like them. What Pikmin would you be? Out of curiosity, since you brought it up. But also a race thing, for sure. I would be a white Pikmin. I'd be a yellow Pikmin? Why is that? Any particular reasoning? Is it because they got noses? They're the ones with noses, right? Do you relate to them having a nose? they can touch electricity. And personally. I think that's a pretty cool. Fair enough. It's a good answer, isn't it? I don't even need to spend a lot of time on this hair. It's just the freaking... It's the fake thumbnail hair. It's not real. It's all extensions and weaves and pieces and stuff. And they can jump higher? Oh yeah, that's true. They can do that. That is a very handy ability in the Pikminverse. But the white Pikmin can carry the fastest. So... kind of pog. Can't be touching electricity. They are immune to poison, though, if I remember right. So that's another thing. That one's not true to me. At all. I'm not immune to most poisons. I haven't checked, but I'm just gonna go out on a limb and say that's true. Also, if an enemy eats a white Pikmin, they hurt? Ooh, that'd be neat. If somebody ate me, I would make sure that it hurt on the way down, at least. I am kicking and screaming, I'm pulling stuff out of my pocket, I'm pulling my keys out of my pocket and dragging myself down the esophagus. If they're eating me, I am gonna make it a miserable experience. I'm trying to grab onto the uvula on the way down. Just on the off chance they barf me up. It's not gonna be pleasant if anyone eats me, that's all I will say. Kicking and screaming, they might think they're pregnant. Because for all intents and purposes, they would be if I was in there. It ain't gonna be good. If I get eaten, I can still be spiteful. That's like my thing. I can do that so easily. No! How? No! No, I'm not a Vor streamer. No! You can't do that to me. You can't call me a Vor streamer. No. I didn't even realize it was happening. This is terrible news. I don't know if I could stream today after that. I'll try. I'll be brave. Oh, you want to see something, mask? By the way, let me go here. Wait, what tab am I on? Yeah, I'm on the right tab. Just going to make sure you're not on any of my secret tabs that I have, that I definitely just leave open on my PC. Have you played The Witcher 3? Like, the first hour? I haven't done much else. I played Gwent. I got to the point in the game where you play Gwent, and then I stopped, because I have no time. But I did play, like, the first couple hours, maybe. I'll get back to it someday, is what I say all the time. Look, I uploaded a thing to the Webtoon application. You can go right now and check out my test series. Because it's there. You can't check out the actual one because there's no episodes, but this one you can check. There's like 6 pages. So that's there. You want to know the crazier thing? Let me click on it. Why is it not work? Oh yeah, it has like 18 views, and I specifically tell people not to read it, and it has a black square for its icon, and people are coming in here, trying to freaking look at my shit. They're not allowed. Going right now. Get out of there. What does it say? What does it literally say? It says don't read it. I can't believe you. One of my own regulars betraying me. Look at all these links I have. Do I even have a Tumblr? I don't have a Tumblr, so I'm... Okay, yeah, it's not popping up. Wait, what? Oh, this is the Webtoons Tumblr. What's happening? Does this go to my Reddit? I'm not sure. What about this? Does this go to my Twitter? This does not. go to my Twitter. Oh, this is how you tweet. You can tweet from this whole thing, or do a Reddit post for. I see. This is for outgoing stuff, not for ingoing stuff. I see. So anyway, yeah, that's my test series. You can see 6 pages of random garbage. Some of it's in order, some of it's not. There's a duplicate in there, I think. But yeah, I checked it. The reason I wanted to do a test episode was to see how Webtoon would format the dimensions. And I didn't know that they do it automatically. So all my big files that are like 17 to 25 megabytes, which would not fit normally, they just handle that for you. They just auto-scale it down. I didn't know they did that. That's very cool. So I can easily fit like 4+ pages in any update. I'm only going to be fitting 2 on average in the future, but that's neat to know that I don't got to worry about scaling my dimensions for Webtoon, because they just do it. They just do it for me, because I'm a lazy idiot who can't handle formatting my own pages. I'm a little baby. They have to help me do everything. I'll just make the comic and you let me put it places, okay? That's all I ask of a website. And I'm still iffy on doing that first part sometimes. You read, liked, and subscribed and comment to my test series that I told you not to read? What's wrong with you? How dare you? You did. You did indeed. It's right there. I see it. You have subscribed to the series. What is your freaking comment? What did you have the audacity to say to me? I'm scrolling right now. Also, these look great on browser, I gotta say. If you want to look at these on PC, I recommend it. They look pretty good. A little blurrier than the source file, but that's gonna happen. PNG test 2, I'm assuming. Goblin Man Zotank, get out of here. Filth. On my do not read of all tests. I mean, while you're there, you can rate a 10-star. Don't. Do not. Wouldn't it be so funny if I could somehow get on the Rising Stars list with just my stupid test pages? That'd be so funny. If that happened, I legitimately wouldn't release the comic. I would make everyone so confused. I would open up another account just to do it. People could find me after the fact if they want, but if my test pages exploded, I would not do anything. Get on the Webtoon staff fresh pick somehow. Is that what it's called? Or am I thinking of Rotten Tomatoes? I'm probably thinking of Rotten Tomatoes. How should this mouth look, though? Maybe just like that. Maybe smaller is the key. Is the music loud enough? It's so quiet on my OBS. Man, I can barely hear the piano. It's just like the opening theme anyway. Oh yeah, I found a new comic that's pretty alright. Should be in my subscribed. Because I just subscribed to it. Where are you at? I'm always looking for some interesting stuff in the canvas section. I don't know why I said it like that. Made it sound way weirder now that I'm thinking about it. Section. There. I said it. Where is it? Oh, it's called Panacea. It's pretty fun so far. Very simple premise at the point that I'm at. There's a lot of them called Panacea, but it's the one that's called Panacea. It's a romance one. It's the only word. I don't normally click on romance series, but this one had neat art, so I kept reading. And then it hooked me, okay? It got me. Freaking, I'm reading it now. Mainly because the romance is not too much of a focus. They have characters with goals, which is the most important thing. And that's all you can ask for. Oh yeah, also I forgot one more thing. While I was making my series, I noticed that I could put in my elevator blurb, my elevator pitch, to describe my series in, like, I think, like, 500 characters. You know, the little thing. The little thing that every series has to hook people in. So I have that right here. If we can read that out. I'll do that after. I'm looking at this face on the monitor and it's messing me up. Here, we gotta fix that. So I'll read that in a bit. It took me a long time to settle on it, too. I looked up tutorials on how to write elevator pitches for your story. Because it's a very different form of writing than, like, anything else. You're so compressed with the space you have. It's, like, even more hyper-fixated on getting details across efficiently than a plot summary. You have, like, 100 words to do it. It's nuts. So I was spending basically all morning just settling on that today. I have not slept yet, which is, yeah, that's what that means if you're catching on. This eye is messed up. I can already see it without flipping the canvas. I just zoomed out and I was like, oh, that's gonna be bad. But it's the thumbnail. So it don't matter, dude. This thumbnail's actually fine. I think that's usually the gist of how I draw the armor guy. The commander, as it were. The music is so quiet, I can barely hear it. That's it, I'm going to something else. I'm going to Xenoblade music. Again. I just like it. Get the definitive edition away from me. I don't want it. Its music is garbo. Compared to the original, anyway. Even though it's literally the same songs. How do you hold people up? Should I be looking up reference for this pose specifically? Maybe. Can you guess what they're saying in this panel? You. What could that mean? It could mean any number of things. Maybe he's saying you win. You know, you win the entire story. You are the protagonist now. I won't confirm or deny. For anyone looking for an update to the Monster Prom streams that occasionally happen on Swan Drawn's channel, randomly, whenever she decides to rope me into that. I lost again. This time I tried to hook up with the Medusa lady. Sorry, I said hook up. That's crass. That's vulgar. Tried to invite her to prom. Liam Core, no. I didn't even talk to Liam once. I don't think he showed up on stream more than once, actually, which was a blessing for me. No, that's not true. I did talk to him once. Or maybe Swan did? I had to speak as Liam one time, which is surprisingly low compared to the other stream. Was it yesterday? Yeah. It was yesterday. It was at the end of her Deadly Premonitions watch party. Yesterday. So if you want to see me absolutely fail again, that's over there for your viewing pleasure. I did not win. I went to watch Barbie. Yeah, how was it? Did you enjoy it? I will after this. All right, I'll run. It was, I'm not gonna spoil the ending. I will spoil that I lost, because that's, no surprise, honestly. Or it shouldn't be. But the way that I lost was the most depressing thing in the entire world. And I do not want to spoil that for you. It's like the last hour of Swan Stream when you go to look for it, just so you're not, scoping around. It was fun. Yeah, nice. Nice. Glad to hear it. My family saw, and we're a little behind on movies, so this was like the most recent film that we watched that came out. John Wick 4. And that was a long movie. That was a long-ass movie. It was so long. And I enjoyed that movie, I'll be honest. I didn't enjoy it as much as the other three. I think the first two are still the strongest ones, and I don't think anyone will fight me too hard on that. But John Wick 4 was aight. It was pretty aight. You know, it's more action movie. Set pieces and whatnot. Pretty good, pretty good. Another movie to indicate how far behind we are on movies as a concept. Well, aside from me buying John Carpenter's The Thing and Princess Mononoke as my Blu-rays of choice recently. We plan on seeing Guardians 3. Guardians of the Galaxy 3. We haven't seen that either. We're just so behind. Guardians of the Galaxy freaking comes out on Disney Plus in like a week. That's how long it's been. Already. And we still haven't seen it. So far behind, dude. I want to see Oppenheimer at some point as well. Speaking of the Barbie movie, since these two movies come in pairs, apparently. I don't know why, but they have. They just have. It's like the Doom and Animal Crossing crossover all over again. Just some gritty war-themed movie, and then just something that you could play at your niece's birthday party in the background. Lupenheimer. I have not heard that one. Okay, let's see. There are boobies in Oppenheimer. Did I mention this already? I'm having a bit of deja vu. No, you have not. I do not believe so. But I have heard about that. I don't know why everyone's so obsessed about the boobs. Other movies have done that. You see Logan? The freaking lady busts those out in front of Wolverine in like the first 2 seconds of the movie. It's crazy. By crazy, I mean it's the most mundane thing imaginable. I agree with Red Letter Media, everyone talking about the boobs specifically. When did we become such prudes, man? Why is this all we can talk about? Like, we all have them. Well, not really. We all have the capacity to have them. As human beings on this earth, as mammals. Of the Homo sapien variety. I do not have them. Hopefully I don't have them in the future, because that would mean I put on a significant amount of weight. Because I don't plan on getting top surgery. That's not my deal. Can be other people's deal? Not my deal. Usually they say top surgery for reductions, though. I guess it would just be implants. I'm not going to get implants. Although, no. perish the thought. But if I did, on my VTuber, sorry, I don't have a VTuber, on my PNG tuber, would I be famous? I've postured this and pondered this before, but I've never gotten a clear answer. That's that thumbnail, I think. And then there's this one. And again, I don't feel like I really need... I can plan out this guy's armor in my head, so I don't really need that. He's pretty simple. Maybe this one up here. And then there's panel 3, which I haven't even settled on doing yet. Let me open up the thumbnails that I had for this. If I could find them. Here they are. Yeah, I got a couple poses. I think I like panel 3 version 2 more. So we'll just copy that one. Now that I'm looking back on it with fresh eyes. Subway eat fresh eyes. Hey, you're supposed to... What the... It's on a different panel. Or layer. I'll teach you to mess with me like that ever again. There you are. Got it. Just mulling over the pacing of this page so far. Seems alright. I don't think we're going to remove any of the panels here. I kind of like all of them being structured on this page. Oh yeah, I forgot I was going to do my elevator pitch, if anyone cares to hear that. I was reading over, like, they recommend for blurbs... I'm preparing my Switch emulator to play Pikmin. Pikmin? Yeah, I get it. PK Men, wow. Is going rough over there. Pidgemin. Alright, well, you could keep going and we'll just come back. I'll check in on you later and we'll see what happened. There he goes. He got... Congratulations, congratulations. Congratulations, congratulations. Mask, I'm worried about you. Only at the, for this moment. When do you think the Dark Moon remaster comes out? Didn't they have a date for it? I did play the original. Ow, I just headbutted my mic. So hard. Originally released for 3DS, will hit Switch next year. Next year, apparently. Ambiguous next year. Which probably means the start of the next fiscal quarter, which I believe happens in March? Could be mistaken, but I think it's March. So I would say late March would be my guess. I don't think they're gonna wait too long. It's just a remaster. of a 3DS game. They're not going to hype it up for like a big Nintendo Direct coming out mid-year or in December, especially December of next year. It should not take that long. Unless they just started working on it, in which case they should still be able to crank it out, you know. I'm just hoping not October. I don't think they'll do that. They only did that for Luigi's Mansion 3 because it was good marketing. We'll get the Americans to buy it on Halloween, and then we did because it's Luigi's Mansion. Duh, it's a spooky ghost game. Of course I'm going to buy it in October, Nintendo. You geniuses, I hate you. Get away from me. But I do got to admit, sometimes they make good decisions. Every once in a while. I can't do this. We're going to my Stream Jams playlist. The music box music is going to kill me. I must get a different playlist of music. Give me the one with copyrighted material on it. Oh yeah. We were talking about contraband. No, not contraband. Contradict. Contradict this? Contradict. Contradictory? Contradictory game? Yeah, contradiction. Spot the liar. And I looked at the designer and composer, and it's Tim Fallon, the guy who did the song you're listening to right now. The Pictionary NES theme. And all of those really absurdly good NES chiptune themes, like the ones for the Silver Surfer game, and there's one for Solstice. But I had no idea he was still doing stuff. Composer and designer of like a FMV adventure game is crazy. It was so weird to see his name ever again. But I'm excited that people actually know about that game, because that game is good. Gotta make this arm look more like he's getting thrown. What does he look like in the past thing? He's got his arm over here, and this one, yeah, this one can go forward. That one will be tossed back a bit more. This song is so good. The instrumentation, I don't really, like, get into a lot of, like, what makes techno music or, you know, any kind of this type of synthetic music, synthwave, I don't know what you call it. You can tell by how not into this subgenre I am, by how little I know about even what it's called. But the instrumentation on this one, I find particularly great. Yowie hand over here. I gotta calm down with that. It's quite simply just too large. What do we do here? What perspective am I even going for? I think he's too freaking large. Maybe this guy's too freaking small. It's all about perspective and your perspective. Yeah, maybe we'll just embiggen him. He is closer to the foreground anyway. He should be larger. Excuse me, Xenoblade, you're kind of popping off right now? You're kind of being, like, so loud. Which I'm fine with, just, like, ask me first. What does this guy's hand look like in the thumbnail? The first thumbnail. What action was I even trying to convey with this? What are you? I can't even identify this as a hand. I know it's supposed to be, but what are you doing? This is the problem. When I do thumbnails and then try to come back to them, I become the editor in this scenario and I have no idea what I was going for. See, if this were the definitive edition version of this song, the Xenoblade 1 song, you would be hearing an opera right now, and it's like, opera has its place, but not in a Xenoblade game. It's just like, but you know, Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition did the thing that every remaster should do, which is let you pick the original music. No idea what he's doing. That's true. Get that emote out of here. Sup, Gero? Welcome in. How are you on this fine afternoon? Gero, what type of Pikmin would you be? That's true. Mask has been asking. He's very desperate to know what kind of Pikmin we would all be. I said the white Pikmin. Because they're fast and weak and scrambly and they have red eyes and it's like, that's just me. He said he would be the yellow Pikmin, because they can jump really high, and they can touch electricity, which he finds pretty cool. Better now with a doctor appointment done? Yeah, that sounds pretty good to me. Good on ya. Oh yeah, I meant to respond to your Discord message, by the way. Yeah, it just slipped my mind, sorry about that. I was going to reply to that, but... my apologies. Kind of left you hanging on the whole, is a collab on Wednesday happening or nothing? Probably the Glow Pikmin? I do like the Glow Pikmin. It's okay, life happens. Yeah, it's my fault. I just feel a little bad. I was, like, heading out the door to work, and I was like, I'll respond to this surely in like an hour. When I'm at work, and I was like, oh well. And then my brain just... it's just gone. What is this hand doing? I'm getting so angry at my own hand. I can't figure out what this hand is doing. Maybe we'll just make him push him. It's like a pushing emotion. Man is doing hand things, clearly. I don't think it is. It's freaking doing the opposite of a hand thing. If it was doing a hand thing, we would have a hand drawn here right now. Freaking get out there. Yeah, we'll just do a push. Just a big ol' shove is what he's doing. Oh yeah, I guess I can go over the freaking elevator pitch and my test series, since I keep forgetting about it. And I keep forgetting about it a lot. I need to go to bed. But not right now, I'm doing other stuff. I'm making a webcomic. I'm fulfilling my dreams, darn you. It's just taking a long time. No one said fulfilling your dreams was easy. If they did, they're lying. Unless your dream is to, like, I don't know, have a peanut butter sandwich. That's a pretty easy dream to fulfill. I wouldn't mind it. Go to my series, go to my dashboard. Excuse me, I said go to my dashboard. There we go. Why does it have 2 likes? Mask, did you have an alt account? Oh, you just hearted both chapters, I see. I thought you had someone else come in here. Anyway, what I'm talking about here is I uploaded a test series to see how my panels would look on mobile. Like, son, what I am explaining at this very moment. So that I could see what my images would look like on Webtoon itself. And I didn't know that they automatically format your images to the dimensions that they need. So that worked out very nice. And I told people not to read it, and then Mask found it immediately. And then he liked both of them. He read both of them in order to like them. I can't believe this. And it has 25 views on here, even though I tell people not to look at it. Go away. It's a black image. I bet we can find it. Let's go to Canvas. Let's go to Fantasy. Sort by date. We could probably scroll for a bit and find my dang thing. Shouldn't even be that far. I mean, actually, a lot of... There it is. I'm on page 3, guys. Sorted by date in the Fantasy category with my black box. There I am. I do like how if you don't have an episode, though, like, it doesn't show up. Because I wouldn't want this to show up. Quite yet. Well, this is here. And I was testing the words and the spacing. And all that. Whoops, I opened Steam. Get out of here. I'm trying to swap to OBS here. Yeah, I don't know if, like, Tapas will do that stuff, where it, like, auto-formats to the dimensions you need of your page. But Webtoon's doing that is pretty neat. Webtoon. Is it Webtoon? Webtoon. So I was doing that. I updated my thumbnail last stream for the comic to better reflect the current design of the pro tag. It's just a lot of minor changes, but I think it does look better as a result. I can bring that up, actually. I don't know if I want to bring up the original image because I'm a little self-conscious about it, because the changes are very minor. But here it is. This is the updated version. And when I brought up the original for comparison, Swandrawn, notorious enemy of the stream, she sounded sarcastic. I don't know if I want to bring it up right now. I'm still a little wounded. Does this work? Yeah, you could have been holding him back here. That works. And then we just have this one to thumbnail. And we should be able to get a decent amount of the line art done today. I count everything except the faces as the line art. Yo, is this Gravity Rush? Hey, Sony. When is the Gravity Rush movie coming out? You said you were working on it, didn't you? And yet we haven't seen anything. Probably canceled. Unfortunately. If they could barely, you know, you hear about the turnover rate and the crunch time that they had to do for just, like, one of their movies that was guaranteed to come out, like Spider-Verse. I don't think the Gravity Rush movie's coming out anytime soon. Or at all. You're telling me we're gonna animate a movie? It's based on a PS Vita game? It came out, like, 10 plus years ago? Absolutely not. This is like when they canceled that Popeye movie all over again. That movie looked sick. If you guys have seen the trailer for the canceled Popeye movie. Such a dope art style. And they, you know what, you want to know what movie they canceled it for that I just remembered? They canceled that movie for the Emoji movie. So instead of a cool Popeye revival, we got the Emoji movie. Yeah, that's good. Good job, Sony. Real good job. I was so happy to hear that. Lame, I know. I can't believe it. The freaking Emoji. The glorified Dropbox sponsorship. Oh yeah, I guess I was talking about that comic I found earlier. I could link it. I'm all for supporting people. In any small way that I can, except for myself. I couldn't give less of a care about if anything I do grows. But other people, I like to see them grow. Shala's theme! Yeah, that's right! See? Someone is cool. And recognizes Shala's theme by the first couple of notes. Of Azure. This arrangement in particular is one of my favorites. It's an orchestral remix by Malcolm Robinson. He doesn't do anything these days, but he used to compose a bunch of stuff orchestral style, or remix it, that is. And he's very good at it. He's good at it to the degree where, like, I realize how much of an art form it is to remix stuff when I see what he does. I was gonna guess OC Remix? Yeah. Someone is cool, Azure? Yeah, he's pretty awesome. Subscribed, Canvas. Oh yeah, it's Panacea. I'm just gonna click on it. I'll put the link here. I tell you, I don't normally click on romance comics, but this one found its way into the fantasy genre. Which is how I found it. This always happens. It's just cute. If you want to read a cute webtoon, this is the one. I will warn you, has a bit of a lore dump at the beginning. But once you get past it, it's pretty good. And that's a lot to say, because normally I don't even make it past the lore dump. It takes quite a bit of something to pick up the pace, to pick up the slack that a lore dump will provide. I have to show you guys this. I don't have all of the context. How am I even gonna... Okay, hold on, I have an idea. Here we go, I can do this. Noted enemy of the stream, Swandron, sometimes comes to me, occasionally, with some of the best manhwa panels that you would ever find in your life. Any webcomic made, like, manhwa made. If there's a ridiculous or absurd panel in it, she'll find it. And so far she sent me two. But so far, they're two of the funniest things I've ever seen. Let me do... I'll open both of them, because I don't know if I've brought up the other one on stream in a bit. Anyway, so this is the first one that she sent me. Swan equals enemy of the stream. That is true. You could write that down. You could put that in. You could chisel that into stone if you want. This is the one note I will accept. So, when you're making a manhwa online, there are very strict deadlines that you must adhere to. Let me turn this down. It's so loud. And sometimes you don't get to finish everything that you want to draw, and you make a little scarecrow hand coming out of this guy's sleeve. And it was the funniest thing. I think when I first saw this, when she showed this to me, I laughed for like 3 minutes in a row. Chicken foot hand. It was the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. I love that. But this is like, in essence, this panel is fine. His head's a little squished. It's a little weird there, but that's another thing. But for the most part, this panel is fine. The moment itself, like the writing, is probably good. It's just a hug. It's probably fine. This next panel that she sent me yesterday, from a manhwa that she was reading, some romance thing, is absurd down to the very concept. And it's like the inverse. This is like, execution is like, what happened? But the concept is fine. This next one is the execution is great. Like, it's surprisingly well done, but I can't explain it, so just take a look at this. Yeah, this is what happened. You'll notice those eagle-eyed of you in the chat. There is a woman dangling from a cliff by one hand in the rain, wet rocks, and a horse is dangling from her ankle by the bridle, which would normally slip out of the horse's mouth, so that would imply that this horse is biting down super hard as to not die. And this woman's leg is not snapped off of her body. Strong woman, titanium bones, even. Herculean strength, exactly. Man is supposed to be saving her, apparently. According to what Swan told me happens in the next few panels. But right, he's just kind of sitting. He's just kind of standing here. So the horse anatomy is whack. He's got some meaty thighs as well. Now, when I say the horse anatomy, it's actually, like, surprisingly well done. Especially for this angle. Human beings were not meant to see a horse from this angle. It just never should have happened. So for that to be taken into consideration, like, this whole thing is well done. But it's crazy that this woman's arm and leg have not snapped off. As a thick horse. He's got a freaking heckin' chonker of a thigh there. Musculature. Makes this one look weak and impotent over here. I see. But yeah, these panels are great. I love both of them. I hope she continues to send me more ridiculous manhwa panels. They were so funny the first time I saw both of them. I don't know how she finds it either. It's probably because I look through the independent sections a lot. Horse toe, skip leg day, all four of them. Toned, muscular, pronounced. But when you're looking through the independent section on any comic providing platform, comic hosting platform, you know, the independent creators usually don't have strict deadline. Like me, for example, it's taken me like 3 months to do 15 pages. I would be fired in any studio with that kind of workflow. I only do stuff for 2.5 hours a day, granted, but even still, it's not an enviable rate. I wish I could do more. But yeah, there's like, you know, we have time as independent people with no deadlines or manager to just take time on these things. Well, what's funny about that one with the horse is that clearly they had enough time to render it well enough. It was just the writing that was ridiculous. Like, why would you put that in your story? Dangling a horse from one leg? That's preposterous. And the way Swan explained it to me, apparently there was some audience outcry about that particular sequence. Naturally, because in the next chapter or whatever release there was, they explained that the woman did not get away from that unscathed, and her her like leg and arm were fractured or something, so there were repercussions to doing that. And I'm just like, alright, well, at least they justified a little bit of that. Speaking of taking time, we need to chat about a commission I want to request from you. By all means, whenever you feel the want to do so, I will be... I mean, you know where to find me. More so than most. You don't even gotta DM me on Twitter. I mean X. Huh? Sorry? Just kind of slipped out there for a second? Elon Musk having a public breakdown and we all just have to watch? Dead name the platform. He dead names his daughter. I did see that meme. I think it's funny. I do agree. We're going to call it Twitter forever. It is Twitter. It's not X. Shut up. The Funger Games? I do like the Funger Games. So you have piqued my interest immediately. Alright, I'll click on it. Let me mute my YouTubes. Shut up, YouTube. What do we got? 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 Lagarde, it says gullible on the ceiling. Oh, wow, it really does. Oh, no, don't do that to Lagarde. Lagarde is an innocent angel and did nothing wrong. You know, well, depending on the playthrough, of course. Your Lagarde may vary. Where should this hand go? Usually when you're drawing an arm, you want to draw where the hand's going to end up first, so it looks natural. It might just be sticking out quite a bit. No, that looks a little comedic if he's like splayed out like that. But maybe that's how it's got to be. This guy has very luscious locks, I will say that. I drew him with a very nice head of hair for a man who's like presumably in his 50s, just based on this character design. Maybe his late 40s? I don't know. Believe it or not, he is a side character. I have not determined his exact age and height and weight. That's not how this works. We gotta fix that. Is that how that works? Maybe this way? Yeah, that should be good for the line art, for the thumbnails, I think. Now we can do the actual thumbnails. I do want to touch up the sleeve because it's bothering me a little bit. But other than this, we should be in the clear to move on to final line art with like an hour. So yeah, I don't know if we'll finish. But I will try getting the line art done. Besides the faces, it's a disclaimer I feel the need to make. The faces are not the line art, they are the faces. Stretch. I don't have a stretch redeem, but I should probably. I got a set of pages from a manga. May I share? You may. Half my For You page is manga. Hydrate or dihydrate? I'm a hydro homie, I'll have you know. I may be bad at stretching, but I am not bad at hydrating. Dihydrate. Carbohydrates. Carbohydrate sounds like a villain that would show up in Captain Planet. I thought you were a peanut butter fiend. That's for food. I gotta have something to wash it down. And so I drink exclusively water. I'm drinking that liquid peanut butter. Sometimes when I'm eating toast with peanut butter on it, it does feel like I could just drink the peanut butter off of that. Because it just melts. Sounds like something Dr. Steve Brule would make an episode on. Sup Stove, also true. Probably pair it with that joke. With like everyone in the history of mankind who has drank water has died. Think about it. If we're talking about dihydracy, yeah. I have uploaded the images. Let me look. How many? If it's more than like 15... Okay, it's 5. I was gonna say. It was a lot. Like the other one, I would wait a bit. But no, it's only 5. Oh my god. Sorry, I skipped to the last one. I spoiled myself. I'm gonna scroll back up. Alright, let's open these in the browser. Oh yeah, Stove, did I tell you? I probably haven't. I'm just telling everyone as they trickle in. So I don't know if you were here or not. Also, here's what Mask sent me. How dare you spoil yourself? When you get to the 5th image that Mask sent me, you too will be like, oh my god, how could I resist? Do I have it? Did I just go to Panacea instead? First of all, Panacea is cool. You should read it. Oh yeah. I uploaded my test images to here, and they have 28 views, so... I'm basically world-famous, renowned comic artist Zotan, and I haven't even released my first episode yet. I'm kind of pretty sick with it. I'm kind of the coolest. Okay, anyway. We have a blushy. This is a very shoujo manga panel. And then we go here. I subscribed. Reading it. Stop reading. It literally says, do not. Do not do that. There's like 4 pages, and then some of them are out of order, and then one is a duplicate. It's not worth looking. There's some blushy crushies here. Sorry to quote Xenoblade 2. Go out with me for a cup of tea. Oh, will you? Sorry, manga. Sorry. SFX nod. There's no sound effect for nodding. Why would you put that there? Japanese comic industry, why do you do this to me? You will? Then let's go together to that cafe. It looks like I'm saved somehow. Everyone's blushing so much in this manga. She's so cute. Okay, here it goes. And then this is the reveal. The prestige, a double page spread even, of this mysterious man. My god. This is barely intelligible as a face. That's how great that panel is. You owe me one. Becomes girl again. Thanks, Aniki. I feel like I've seen this before, but I could not pinpoint it for the life of me. Aniki is too amazing, isn't he? He's pretty freaking sick. Pull the Jody did. But that was very good and I liked it. There's some more. But I only posted the best ones. You did, I will say, you did find a good selection. I forgot again, I have an elevator pitch for my series. And I'm gonna read it. Because it took me all morning and I'm proud of it. So we're gonna read the thing. We're gonna keep the music going because otherwise I'll feel self-conscious about it. This is the elevator pitch. Omen be her mark, a fate worse than death. In a monastery hidden amidst frigid peaks, Faye has always wanted to see what lies beyond its walls. When she gets the chance, she may wish she hadn't. Forced into a land of dying gods and blighted soil, she finds the help of a man who's wise to its dangers. A lone huntress wise to its beauty, and a swordsman who truthfully could not give a damn. She'll need them and more, though, to fend off the many who, for some reason, keep saying she shouldn't exist. What do you think? What do you like it? Do you like it? What do you like it? That's not even a sentence. What the hell is going on? So how long did it take to confirm the correct spelling of Hutzpah? 2 seconds and one Google search. That's all you need in the modern era. I do the like it. Thank you for responding in grammatical phrasing that I can understand. Otherwise, I'd be so pissed that I couldn't understand what you were saying. It took me so long to look up a bunch of blurbs this morning in the fantasy genre. Because you can't do... There's like a thing where they tell you to look up bestsellers in your genre, but not the top bestsellers. Because people like your George R.R. Martins and your... Brian Sanderson? Is that the big fantasy artist or fantasy author these days? Whatever his name is. You can't just take ideas from their blurbs because they're already famous and they can do whatever they want for their blurbs. So you have to like take the bestseller genre and scroll down a bit and see what the people actually still trying are doing. If I wasn't already interested, it would 100% have caught my attention. Nice. That's the goal. I have now read it. Looking good, son. Thank you. Thank you. It's been a long time coming and it's still freaking coming. It's gonna take, unfortunately, a little bit longer. I'm gonna hit you with the Kickstarter CEO mantra. The rocket ship is on the launch pad, people. We just need a little bit more fuel. And we'll get this thing going. And then there's a ukulele playing in the background. I found a polar bear isekai. Guy becomes bear. Get isekais out of my chat. If you ever type the word isekai in my chat, I will throw up. Just keeps coming and it don't start coming. How dare you say the truth? I mainly wanted to see if the speech bubbles were legible at mobile scale. And they looked pretty good. So I was fine with my test episodes. I think they were a success and I didn't even have to do anything, which was very nice. What a surprise. I just did a thing and the website did it for me. Technology made my life easier. Which is a rarity. Excuse me! What am I looking at? What did I just say? Alright, well, I'm just freaking... Ugh, it's been fun. It's been real. Hasn't been real fun, but, you know, we'll just freaking, ice this fool. Freaking snipe him. Defiance, that's what. Get him out of here. There's no rebellions and uprisings and upstarts in my chat. Poor Mask, not poor Mask. Poor me. I told him. And then he did it anyway. I am the poor one. Even though I have a job. I'm poor in spirit. Not in terms of fiscal gain. I'm actually more wealthy than I've been in a long time. Which is not a lot. There was not a high bar, but it's saying something. I could buy, like, I don't know, like a desk, for example, but I won't, but I could. I could buy a mountable keyboard tray, but I won't. Figured out how to get out of the no. Not yet. Working on that part. Buy the desk. No! I need to buy so many other things. The list of which escapes me. But it's totally real. Mm-hmm. I have noticed. One thing is nice about this comic. It's a documented process of things actually improving. Artistically, I got better over the course of chapter one into this chapter, and I've noticed it. Normally, I don't notice such things, but this time I did. I will find out where you live, not really, and I'll ship you a desk. I can't help but notice you didn't say, not really, after the ship a desk part. Just the first part. You made explicit notice to just do it halfway through the sentence, and not at the end. Frightens me a little bit. Also, the easiest way to find out where I live is to just start an Etsy page. I'll probably find my way over there eventually. And then you'll just have my mailing address. When I buy something from it. We'll buy a desk, slap a 4 Zotan sticker, it'll find its way. I mean, no joke, that's the name I put on packages I buy from platforms like Etsy now. It's not like I live in an apartment, so I could just put my stream name on anything. And they haven't withheld a package yet for any reason of suspicion, so I'm just gonna keep doing it. I don't need to give every Etsy seller my real name. They don't need to know. They get my weird name. And not my, you know, they can keep the fake name, because the real name, which I would never say out loud, is so embarrassing. I mean, who wants to find out that I'm named Bartholomew? That would kill me. If people figure that out. My throne uses Garrow, yeah. It's good to just have a fake name. An alias, a username. A brand? No. I minored in marketing and went to graphic design classes. But I don't have I still barely know a thing about brand identity. Other than how to make a lot of PSD files. That I can do. Don't document that. I do think it's funny, every time I check the About Me page, it's still empty. I haven't done anything with it. Probably should, but I don't have lore. I've spent zero time actually thinking of lore. See what the emote is called? I believe I did once, I forgot though, let me click on it. Yeah, I did see that. Noted for someone. I won't name names. You have lore. I also noticed the thumbnail didn't appear properly for me. What thumbnail? For the test image? I just uploaded a black box, in case you were wondering. So if you see a black box, it's working as intended. Oh, okay, yeah, that was it. If you want to see the actual thing, I haven't. In my other thing, series. I go back. Gotta go back again. This is the real one. There's nothing in there yet. Here, I'll click on it. It just says, make an episode, you dummy. So that I could back out. And then this is the test one. With nothing. Oh, I've realized that I'm not even on browser. This is the test one. Let me explain everything I just said. Over again. This is the real one. Over here. With no episodes. This is the test. Talking to myself. More than usual. Just explaining things to no one. This is a test. No, it was, and it's true. Now, for those of you who have been carefully paying attention to the remixes in my playlist, this is a Isabel remix of Put Your Records On. And it does get flagged when I upload it. So that's cool. Made by Louis Zong. If you haven't seen his channel, it's a very good channel. I recommend it. He made his most recent video, I think it's called Miku Barbershop Quartet, and I enjoy it. I've listened to it like 3 times. He makes a lot of just original music content. Creative stuff that you don't see often. And also, he's been a storyboard artist on some, like, surprisingly big projects. Those are your streams on YouTube as fuck, because sometimes there is a half hour. No, is that real? I didn't know it got that bad. Yikes. Maybe I should be a little more careful. Oh man, good times. I had no idea it was as egregious as a half an hour. That's funny. I assumed I talked over it enough sometimes to hide it. You know, like some audio jungle stuff. Probably cutting out all my best bits and goofs and jokes, of which there are, like, at least 4. Sometimes, but I think when you get quiet, then it realizes that does happen sometimes. I do focus mode occasionally. Not often, but sometimes. This has to be fixed. It's been happening a lot recently. I've just been throwing words in where they don't belong. have to give her a shoulder, excuse me. She does not have one currently. I'm gonna have to keep speaking now. I'm self-conscious. This is a very flaggable song. What do I talk about? I don't think many of you guys heard the story about how some guy plowed into my mailbox. Not at my mailbox, but the mailbox of my home that I live in, that I inhabit. Fell asleep at the wheel. He's okay, which is the only reason I feel okay talking about it. But we have a new mailbox now, long story short. And it's smaller than the first one, so that's the only thing I'm upset about. I lost my funny manga panel TikToks. You gotta save them, dude, for this moment. This arm looks ridiculous. Oh, get out of here. Princess Mononoke, y'all. One of the best movies ever made. And that is not up for debate. At least not over here. Now, I don't think Ponyo is as well respected as it should be. I've always felt that, and I feel like saying it again. Does anyone even... I feel like people who judge that movie watched it one time. And they have not seen it since. Here's the thing, though. I liked it. And I also only saw it one time and haven't seen it since. So, am I really that much better? At least my one-time viewing experience is blinded by positivity. Instead of negativity. I loved Ponyo C. Some people out there, again, are cool, because they agree with me. Saw three times in the theaters, I did not do it that much. Maybe I'll watch it again, later. Just to remind myself what it's like. The heck is a thumb? Why do we have them? How do they work? Not like this, I can tell you that much. Maybe we can just, like, pretend it's not real. We'll just pretend it's not real. Now, Mononoke, I would not mind seeing in the theaters. I have never seen it in theaters, but I know they oftentimes re-release it in theaters, and they're doing it again this year. I think it's the dub, though, or maybe they have the subs, too. I would not be watching the dub, I will say that. Mononoke dub is notoriously cringe. One of those, just get a bunch of celebrities, that'll help it sell in America. And nobody will hate this... literally a month after we release it for being awful. Spoiler alert, everyone hated it a month after they released it because it was awful. I think that would go for most dubs of a Ghibli movie. I haven't seen most dubs of most Ghibli movies because I try to just speak. I try to stay safe out there. Steer clear of that kind of thing. Wear my dub helmet. Dubs can be a hit or miss, very much so easily a miss as well. So often. You know what I'm curious about, though? There is that new project coming out, Lazarus, from the director of Cowboy Bebop and what have you. And I wonder if they're going to go full commit to quality on the dub casting for that. Because the Cowboy Bebop dub is, obviously, we all know, one of the best out there. Mr. Steve Bloom on vocals. For sure. Gonna be a banger. First Slam Dunk is in theaters, right? The first Slam Dunk? Like right now? The first Slam Dunk. You know what? It is. at least it's in a theater near me. I had no idea. Release date, wait, hold on. Release date USA, July 28th of this year, and yet it's in a theater close to me at 7 p.m. What? This is hurting me. Tomorrow. Yeah, but it's like here today, according to this. I'm gonna click on this. I'm gonna make sure. No, yeah, it's literally subtitled in English, 7 p.m. I could see this a day early? Yo. I mean, I can't, but I could, you know? Like, if I had the means and the time. I wanted to read Slam Dunk for a while, haven't gotten to it. I haven't read it. I've read, or I've seen pages from it. But I do know Inoue, for sure. And I have read Vagabond, because how could you not? Have you seen it? It's crazy. How does he do that? The answer is he did for a long time and then stopped, so... Like a smart man. Very thick vest material, let me slim that down a bit. He also has that other one where they play wheelchair basketball, which is like ridiculously well illustrated. I think it's called Real. Yeah, it's called Real. I want to read that one. Was this man's face? Alright, that's that man's face. Alright, gotta check out this profile. There we go. Okay. Committed to memory. Ponyo mid! No, I actually like the movie a lot. You can't do that. These bait and switches, I'm not prepared. But also, yeah, I agree. Good film. From what I remember. Again, been a long time. But I remember liking it a lot. I'll have to check it out. I want to read an older manga, but getting my hands on it would be expensive. An older one, you say? Just do what I do. Just buy a $200 box set for no reason. We can all just do that. I mean, in all seriousness, no, I do not regret that purchase. Claymore is goated. Everyone should read Claymore. Or watch Claymore. Just don't watch the ending of Claymore. You can read the ending of Claymore, just don't watch the ending of Claymore. Especially like when they are going around on the big handle boat. Yeah, I do like that scene. I do remember that scene. Post pirated links in my chat room. Ghost Hunt is no longer in print. I believe you've brought Ghost Hunt up before. For the low end, 800, and for the high end, 1,000. Owie. That one hurt to look at with the eyes. Looking it up again. Yeah, I do recall you bringing this one up. Oh my god, you're right. On Mercari, it's like a friggin' $1,000. Oh my god. I do want to own it at some point. I mean, yeah, that would be like a really cool collector's thing at this point. It would be one of those manga that you read like once every few years and then put back in a plastic sleeve. Because you just, it's like $1,000, dude. You're reading it with rubber gloves on. But that isn't anything compared to Umi Neko manga. Some of them are over 1,000 per volume. Looking that up right now. I wonder which volumes. Oh, it's probably this, like this one that's $200 for volume one. Yowza. They were limited release. Why people gotta do that? Why they gotta make things so hard? Just release things forever, please. For me. What if I'm late to the party and I want to pick it up someday? Then it's $200 a volume. 200 bucks a pop, dude. Crazy. I ain't got that kind of money. I'm not elongated muskrat. I'm wearing a hat right now, in case you can't tell, and I keep headbutting the microphone. I know my goblin's not wearing a hat, but I am most certainly wearing a hat right now. We own them all, but a friend of mine wants them all, but didn't get them when they were being released. Ooh, that's gotta be an awkward situation. Yeah, we do just own all of the things that you've ever wanted. Your lack of initiative has cost you, What a grievous error. Got into the series later. I see. See, that's what I'm talking about. Like, that's what would happen to me. Measure was interested from day one, yeah. You get the... What is it called? The early adopter benefits. Special privileges. For being real ones and supporting the series early on. What does his hair look like? It looked fine in the thumbnail, but now it looks weird. Maybe it's because I was doing it wrong? Yeah. Whoa, I zoomed way out. I mean, people want the visual novels are available on Steam, but the manga is still pretty amazing, yeah. I would imagine that. It's like the Steins Gate visual novel. They're out there, but I'm pretty sure there's mangas also. But those are probably still in print. Is there a Steins Gate manga? There simply must be. There is. It's probably not expensive, though. Let me check. It's not. I mean, it's a little pricey, but it's not like limited release Umineko stuff. It's like 100 for volumes 0, 1, 2, and 3. Actually, it says complete collection 1, 2, 3. Is it 4? It looks like 4. It is 4. Let's do this, a little sideburns. The manga art style changes per arc. That's pretty neat. Like artist as well, or just the art style? Because one of those is way more wild than the other. Artist and style? That's crazy that they just churn them out like that. You're in, you're out. Sorry, it's a new arc. What could we say? We didn't say it would be a stable job when you got in here. Said it was an Umineko job. Umineko, sorry. Pronunciation hard. It is done on purpose. I mean, I imagine. It doesn't sound like a production cycle issue. If it was, that would be very funny, though. That they just kept forgetting and had to get a new guy. We didn't re-up the contract. We need a new one. Helps with the storytelling interest. Because I'm trying to think to myself, in what way would changing an art style help? Is it just like the passage of time, or is it like different perspectives of different characters, or what's going on? Each arc is a new game, so the story, although the same, is told differently. So new perspectives. Kind of. Well, I do kind of get it, though. It's hard to explain without spoilers, yeah. His hair looks small here. Yeah, his hair was much bigger over here. Let me embiggen the hair. Which is something I have always said and will continue to say for a long time. Still, his hair still looks weak and impotent. I need bigger hair. Virile, lively hair. Need to make the hair bigger. Shocker, is that my fault? It's just my character. It's my sensibilities and my predilections. And how I am and who I am. You know who to blame. I've brought it up before. It's this one's fault. It's her fault. Right here. This is the one, officer. Also, my god, the images got way spicier than I thought they did when you look up Aisha Clan. Oh my god. I should have expected that, though, to be honest. Nobody narc. Her and every other 80s anime character. It's their fault. They have cool hair. They do see. I'm not alone, and I never was. I mean, that's part of the reason I follow that GRS comic artist on Twitter. The other reasons should be apparent when you click on their profile. But they do have very good sensibilities for that retro style. Loved Outlaw Star have the Blu-ray interest. I should get more anime Blu-rays. I got Mononoke. I imported the dang thing, so I should just get more. But like actual series. The problem with an anime series on Blu-ray is that there's multiple discs and they're like, it's like $60 to buy a set of your average anime. Not to mention the ones that have been going on for a long time, like one of my favorites, you got Hunter x Hunter over there. And buying a box set of that is... Why? Why would you do that to me? Don't you love me, Togashi? Don't you care about me at all? He doesn't care about any of his readers. That's why he makes some pages of his manga entirely dialogue boxes and speech bubbles. It's crazy how he does it. And just doesn't care. Box set JJBA. All the Blu-ray except for Stone Ocean. That's pretty good. It's a pretty good haul. Pretty sure if I brought JoJo's into my house, they would just stare at my... I don't think my parents would ever look at me the same. Just be very confused for like an hour, and then they would say, please let us watch sport or news or anything else. Like the hunky men of JJBA, you can note that if you like. You can also add an addendum, a little asterisk to them. I also like the slim fashionista type men of parts 5 onwards. So there you go. You could put that one on the list. I like Araki's entire character shift from hunky men to fashion models. I will say the transitory period between the two was a little rough. You see the early stages of part 4? It's like, oh, he is trying something new. You can see it happening, but it's like, it's not pretty. It takes a while to get somewhere good, but he does get somewhere good, to be fair. By the end of part 4, he has figured out his new style, and it's good to see. But like, wide chin Josuke does exist. Part 3 style Koichi also exists. The rare cursed early Koichi. With the freaking, like rounded tire sleeves that everyone still had for a while. I don't know why, where he picked that up. Araki, it's just freaking, everyone has, like, Goodyear tires stuck under their shoulders. And that's just how it was for a while. Even the children, they had jacked delts all the time. Nobody was safe. Baby stand. All right, now I made a promise to myself that I would not draw faces for the early line art, and I will hold myself true to that. Because it takes too much time. Faces are not line art. Faces are faces. That's my philosophy on the stream. Scoliosis Josuke. Scoliosuke. I posit that to you. What do you say to that? Welcome back, Max. Gotta be careful about this beak part of the helmet. Sometimes I make it too short and I imagine a cranium inside of here and I'm just like, that would be so flat. So I gotta make sure to make this tall. Too big of an eye hole there. Smaller. More menacing. Man, how does anyone ever say Xenoblade 2 is better? Even the soundtrack, even though Xenoblade Chronicles 2 has a great soundtrack. Like, this is the Xenoblade 1's soundtrack. You just know what it is. We're looking at height differences. Koichi looks like he's 3 foot tall. He absolutely does. What is his canonical height? Did they ever give that? So that we can laugh at how inaccurate it is? He is 5 foot four. No, he is not. Wish I could name Pikmin individually to get emotionally attached. I'm glad that they don't have that feature, specifically because of people like you. 5'2"? Absolutely not. If he's 5'2", everyone else is 6'8". Maybe even taller. Like 10 feet tall. They're like double his height in some panels. Absolutely not 5'2". How do I draw this shoulder pad, plate, pauldron thing? Armor. I think this should be good enough. It gets the idea across. There's gonna be so many people, if this comic ever blows up, that just look at my early armor drawings and they're like, that doesn't even make sense. And I'm gonna be like, yeah, you're right. You're correct. It does not. You draw with the tablet and the PC? I do. I used to draw, I have my monitor, and I have my drawing tablet in front of it on a little stand here, and then I have the keyboard off to the side on a stool, we all know this, my PC's up here somewhere. It looks exactly like this, by the way, 100%. And, they both have displays, but for some reason, over the course of using, my tablet and my PC, this stopped working as a display. But it still works as a touch screen, and I think it's healthier anyway, but what I do is I draw on this while looking at my monitor with my eyeball. I look at that like here. I think it's healthier because otherwise I would be hunched over looking down at this, and the reason people usually do that is so that they have like direct hand-eye coordination to what they're drawing. But my singular eyeball, I have an eye injury, didn't tell you guys about. Here it is. I'll update that in the character model. Never. But yeah, I'm using the old school disconnect. Like if I just had a Wacom, like $50 bamboo tablet with no screen on it, and I was just drawing and looking at my monitor, I'm basically doing it how I used to. But I do think it's healthier because I'm not hunched over looking at my screen. What song is playing right now? This is Song of the Ancients from Nier Replicant. It's a very good song. Nier Automata, I think? No. Wrong. First one. How dare you? Frick. You step to me with Nier trivia. You best not miss. Okay, so it is the one that you play often. I couldn't tell if it's something I heard Azure play or if it was from your streams. I play this one all the time. And I'm proud of it. Honestly, Azure could play it more. He could stand to play it more often. If he's not playing it already. Everyone could stand to play this song a little bit more off. Do I want to draw the rest of the armor down here? We'll worry about that when we get there, I guess. Actually, I guess I could rough it out here. What would actually show? I guess the chest piece would go down to about here. So, yeah. I'll worry about that. How much time we got? We got like 10 minutes. I haven't played any of the Nier games. I have Automata, just haven't played it yet. I know it's a Drakengard spinoff, though. Yeah. It's weird. It's like a continuation of one of the Drakengard endings. So only one of the endings is canon. And that's the spinoff timeline that they continued. I think it's pretty neat. Even though I haven't even played Drakengard, I can still appreciate how weird it is that they did that and how cool it is anyway. And I do think it's funny that Yoko Taro himself dunks on Drakengard for having the gameplay that it does. He's just like, yeah, it's just not fun. I'm sorry that my story is attached to such a boring game for people. Because I don't like it. He's right. He's right. Did Drakengard pop off? No. Nier Automata did. And then Replicant did after they redid the combat entirely. Sorry, it's also called Gestalt. It depends on what region you're in. It's very dumb. Nier is very dumb in terms of its release. You have Dragon's Dogma 2? That's wild, because that game isn't out yet. If you have the first one, that game is phenomenal. If you have Dragon's Dogma 2, you legally have to tell me. Because I am coming over. I'm sorry. I have to. Just for, like, at least 50, you have to show me the game. Yeah, the first one. What am I saying? I don't know. It's kind of funny, though. To believe, even for a moment, that Mask had obtained Dragon's Dogma 2. In somehow, some way. I was willing to believe in that universe. Wholeheartedly, for the record. Nier's really dumb. No! Don't send that to Yoko Taro, please. At least wait until I have 2B fan art to make it up to him, because he loves 2B fan art. That's one thing you gotta know about Yoko Taro. He loves that. It is what you said, though. I know, but don't, like, send it to him. Just because it's the truth doesn't mean you have to send it places. I hope I get to the level of notoriety someday where I can just say, give me your fan art of my OCs, and then like thousands of people would be like, yes sir, right away sir, and then they would just do that. That'd be like a dream come true. Yogotaro was just like, yeah, draw me any 2B fan art you want, send it to me. The spicier the better, he said. I'm paraphrasing, but that was roughly what he said, honestly. And then people did it, and he was like, I assume he had a very good rest of his afternoon. I would. Just letting his inbox fly. This hair looks stupid. And it must disappear. Oh, I heard it. That was the shamisen. I heard it. Did you guys hear it? There it is again. I can spot it a mile away. You know, I was looking up, I was browsing the writing subreddit, because I do that now. Because I'm a wannabe writer, I'm working on it. We'll see what happens. Results remain to be tested. In an actual, clinical trial. Amongst a jury of my peers? No, now I'm conflating things. But amongst other people, you know, people haven't told me whether or not my writing's bad yet, so it's kind of in a liminal space. But I do browse the writing subreddit. And they have, someone brought up an interesting observation that I thought was pretty cool. And it was when I was researching how to write blurbs as well, which was surprising to me. It was how to use descriptive language effectively. And one of the primary things they observed was that books written before, like, the 1800s, before the invention of screen and television and photography, they used a lot of physical sensations for descriptors that were more than just sight. After the TV and photographs became popular, like he says, after the 1990s, every book kind of just like shifted. Or like a majority of them, there was an industry shift towards visual language and visual descriptors. Like things you would just see. But before the 1800s, everything was described, every sense was outlined, because that's what books were back in the day. They described everything in your head because visual storytelling wasn't as well developed. You had like theater. And that's about it. But you know, you gotta target your senses of touch, smell, taste, all that. How does a surface feel to you? Describe that to your reader. In a word. And it was interesting to note, and it helped me with my blurb. I'll probably apply it even more in the future, but it was an interesting thing to note. Just be more aware of, like, the senses that you can describe. I like when written media uses all the senses. I don't have visual thoughts, so it's hard to read. Yeah. I get it too, and it makes sense. Like, just a more fully encompassing experience in the written language. Of course, it's going to be more engaging. Why is it so quiet? I love this song. Crank this song. Oh, Bear McCreary, you did it again. I was skeptical for most of God of War Ragnarok's soundtrack, but then he pulls this one out and I'm like, oh, yo, won me back over. Bear, you got me. You mad lad. I knew you had a good one in you. Also, hurdy-gurdy. Funny instrument, very good instrument in this particular song. Can you play Silver for Monsters, please? You know what? Let's do that now, because I'm about to end soon anyway. Sorry to interrupt Rabe's Lament, because I like it. Yeah, we'll do that one. It's because he uses the silver sword for the monsters. That's the thing. It's not like a tip your waitresses type phrase for monsters. But it could be. Couldn't it? Maybe a cockatrice does need money. Or a hippogriff? Do you fight hippogriff, or are they just griffins in that game? Hippogriff is like a mythological thing. Excuse me, don't yell at me. I'm just live streaming? I'm just like a guy. I'm just level one goblin. Please do not yell at me. This is the kind of vocals I can get behind. You don't got any lyrics to focus on. This weather needs to stop. I know, we got rain like for the next week up here. I don't know if that's what you got going on, but that's what's been happening. Also, it's hot. Hot and rain. I don't like it. It's humid. That's a short song, but I imagine it would loop for like 4 minutes. Plus. Now I just need something random. With heat advisory. Smoke from Canada. Yeah, we do be getting the Canadian smoke over here. That good stuff. No, it's not. It's not good. And thunderstorms later today. We had thunderstorms earlier up here. And we're probably going to have more by the sounds of it. So that's Pog. As long as they stay a reasonable distance away so I can sleep. I hate getting woken up by thunder. It's literally impossible to get back to sleep after that happens. Alright, before I run the risk of drawing the rest of this panel for like another 30 minutes, I'm gonna call it here. Could draw this hand, I could finish her sleeve, but I'm gonna call it. We got some line art done, and we did the thumbnails for the page. The actual thumbnails. I don't like thunder either. Yeah, it's freaking lame. My dog hates it. So that makes it worse. Oh yeah, what do we got? Oh yeah, I did my vertical thumbnail, in case you guys want to see that. You guys like my logo? I did it in Photoshop like 3 years ago. I think. Maybe like two? I don't know. Have a good rest of your day. Thanks for streaming. You as well. You're welcome for streaming. Everyone make sure to read my test pages. There's four of them and they're out of order and they tell you not to read them. And I looked up how to spell chutzpah. So yeah, that's what I was doing. Well, that's it for me. Tomorrow, probably be doing stuff. You know, probably. Unless I'm sleeping. But yeah, thanks for stopping in. And buh-bye.